Hello, lovely people. Welcome back to Ravi's Focus Hive. I am presenting 4 episode series on feedbacks and how to give feedbacks. The first episode, we concentrated on a model called as GROW. In today's episode, we are going to talk about SBI model. Now, you'd ask, why am I doing this? The whole idea is we all should be working towards giving the best feedback. I don't want anybody to give feedbacks like this.
Jesus H. fucking popsicle, I still don't have my billing reports, but you've got time to sit here and Google your ass off. Well, I know one thing. You've got your review coming up next week, and I can't wait to start checking me off some big fucking boxes. Attitude. Poor performance. Poor management skills. Poor works well with others. Ha! That's a fucking joke.
What is this bullshit? Who's this prick?
Some loser gets his head blown off in the Metropolitan.
Shut the fuck up!
Well, I know I'm exaggerating, but let's start looking at the tool that I'm going to describe today. Well, all 4 models that I'm talking about, I will suggest you to use them in certain situations, such as GROW model. The GROW model, you're going to utilize it when you're coaching an individual or a team. Similarly, SBI model, you might want to use when you are working with your peers, when you want to impart a positive or a negative or a corrective feedback to your peer. You would utilize the SBI model. I mean, you can utilize it any which way, but this is my personal suggestion. And because of my own experience, I feel SBI is the best suited model to work between peers. So what is SBI model? SBI model is very simple. It is a model that helps you let the person know what the situation was, what did they do, and how did you feel by their actions. Very simple. If you do it the right way, you get the other person realizing their mistakes, and they themselves will be able to suggest the corrective actions or will be able to accept and move forward by not repeating it. To explain the SBI model, I'm going to share a story from my personal experience. And back in the day, when I had a very large team, I had some set of really senior individuals. And so every time I used to go for a meeting or call upon a team meeting, this one individual would sit at the back and would be busy in his cell phone and not pay attention to the topics or discussions that we will be having. There are ways and tricks that you could involve that person by asking them within the meeting, by asking them to contribute to the discussion, or maybe crack a joke. But all of that said and done, this continued. So I had to correct it. So we had a meeting. So a couple of things very important before I get into explaining the whole story. The first thing is, you cannot delay your feedback. The feedback has to be timely. If an event has happened 6 months ago, you cannot come today and give a feedback. It's gone, it's stale, it's forgotten. You can't talk about it. So you should ensure that it is fresh in the memory of yours and of the individual, so that you guys can talk facts and there'll be less judgments. Now that's very important, that you need to time your feedback. It should be not too late. The other thing is, when you're giving feedback, you have to be very factual. You cannot be very judgmental. You have to only give the facts, right? You don't judge the person at all, because they are any which way defensive, and by judging them and making them feel bad, you're not really helping. So given these 2 points, let's continue and come back to the story. So we both get into a meeting room and I use the SBI model, right? So the situation, so I have to explain the situation first, SBI model. So the situation. So yesterday when we had the team meeting, you remember, right? So yesterday we had a team meeting, everybody was there, and we were talking about how to improve our customer satisfaction. And while I asked everybody to give in their inputs, I was hoping that everybody contributed, and especially from the seniors folks, I was expecting some more responses. This was the whole situation that happened yesterday. Now, why are we here? I want to explain you something that you were doing in that meeting and how that felt. So throughout the meeting, I was noticing you, and I don't know if you noticed or not, I did crack a couple of jokes, tried to grab your attention, but you were too engrossed in your phone. And that's something like everybody was looking at you and you were not paying attention to anything that we were talking. You were completely on your phone. I don't know if you were responding to a customer query on the through an email or updating a case or maybe searching something on Google. I really don't know. And I don't want to kind of say anything wrong or right here. It's just that you were too busy on the phone and not really paying attention to what we were talking. And by doing that, what happened is I felt that the topic or the items that we were discussing was not important to you. And it made me feel that I did wrong by inviting you. And I was like, and it was like, I'm wasting your time. So I think if you are not comfortable to be part of such meetings, you can decline the meeting. You can tell me that you have other work at that time and you can continue to do that. But if you are in the meeting, I would want you to be present and be contributing to the discussion. So since I discussed about this and explained him in these three phases, and also gave him some action items suggesting that if he was busy or if he was not comfortable attending the sessions, he could be open to decline the meetings, or he could come and tell me that he's not available at that point in time. And if required, we could either reschedule or he could listen in or just review the MOMs. So after we discussed all of this and I opened the action items for him, he was happy to understand the whole situation, behavior and impact of it. And he opened up and he told me that he was not comfortable in declining my meeting and he was obliged to attend because it was his manager who called the meeting. And having this discussion, he opened up and I was able to understand that he was feeling really weird of that meeting and he was obliged to attend it. So I clarified to him that it is not required, at least while you work with me, you don't have to be obliged to attend my meetings unless you have something to contribute, right? Unless you have to, either you contribute something to the meeting or you learn something from the meeting. If either of these are not happening, then you are open enough. I am open enough to see your rejection on my meeting invite. And that's all okay. No judgments around there. We all are grown up and we all understand the importance of time. And since then, till the time we were working together, I never saw him on phone in the meeting. And he would openly decline meetings when he were busy. And he would attend when he was comfortable attending, and whenever he attended, he was attentive in the meeting. So I achieved my goal. And for you also, I mean, maybe you're already using this model and now me presenting it to you, probably you will have an epiphany and understand that, wow, you have been using it. So good job if you have been using it. If you have not been using it, start to try and read a little bit about SBI model. Put it into action, put it into practice, and I bet you will enjoy the feedback sessions and those difficult conversations that has been a nightmare so far. Believe me, it's magical. So next episode, we are going to talk about how to get feedback. In two episodes, we have discussed about how to give feedback. The next episode, we're going to talk about a tool which tells us how to get feedback. As a manager, as a leader, as a boss, sometimes you kind of keep asking people and they don't give you any feedback. They'll say, oh, everything is okay. Yeah, good, good, very good. You're the best. And you never know, you're not the best. And probably there are things that they don't like. So I'm going to share a tool with you which will help you extract those important feedbacks on which you yourself can work on, improve yourself and be the best leader for your team. So stay tuned. We'll catch up again this weekend. I will be talking about this other tool. Bye-bye.